Think fast. Off you go, lads.
Yes, well, that's it then for another day. 2,163 officers and men, 541 pounds of rice, issued at 4 ounces per man. My one bag was short 10 pounds, with a balance 20 and a quarter pounds. Dysentery?
Yes. Got it back bad today, sir. Thank you, sir. See you next week.
Yes, take care now.
Don't bother. Sorry, sir. Careless.
This way it's been tampered with, sir.
What? It's impossible, let me see. No, it's not been tampered with. This is merely a corrective hole. This particular weight was probably a fraction heavier than it's supposed to be. You had me worried there for a moment.
They've all been tampered with.
No nonsense, they're just corrected.
Don't give me that, Colonel. I know enough about weights and measures to know holes aren't allowed. There's no such thing as corrective holes. If the weight's wrong, it's never issued. Quartermaster, what do you know about this?
Nothing, sir.
I don't believe you.
You can't accuse me, sir. I don't know anything about it.
All right, we'll put it to the test, shall we? I'm going to go outside, I'm going to show everybody this, and we'll see what they do.
Now, wait a minute, sir.
You're right. But it wasn't me, sir. It was the Colonel. He caught me pinching a bit of rice and he said he'd turn me in if I didn't help him.
Shut up, you fool. Oh, you're not going to listen to that, I hope, Lieutenant. The fool's just trying to implicate me. I had no idea this was going on.
But he's got the key, sir. The key to the safe where the weights are kept.
It couldn't have been me, sir. You know that.
Shut up, Blakely.
Now, shut up. Do you hear me?
How long have these weights been in use, Colonel? A year, 2 years?
I've no idea, Lieutenant. And if they have been fixed, it's nothing to do with me.
But you have the key and you keep them locked up, don't you?
Yes, but that doesn't mean that...
Well, haven't you ever looked at the bottom of the weights?
No, I haven't.
Well, isn't that a bit odd?
No, it isn't, and I won't be cross-questioned, Lieutenant.
Well, you'd better be telling the truth, Colonel.
Are you threatening me, Lieutenant? Because if you are, I'll have you court-martialed.
I don't know about that, sir. I'm here legally, and the weights have been tampered with, haven't they? Haven't they?
I suppose so, yes, but
right.
That doesn't mean that I'm...
I tell you what it means, Colonel. It means that either you or Blakely's responsible, or both of you. You're the only two allowed here.
It wasn't me, sir. I swear to God, I only got £1.10.
Now, will you shut up?
Please, sir, please, don't say anything. They'll tear us to pieces.
I hope they do, Blakely.
Listen, Gray, we can sort this out. Maybe someone has meddled with them, but the amount is insignificant. Now, Blakely, wait outside.
Stay where you are, Blakely.
There's no need for Blakely to go, is there, sir?
No. Walls don't have ears. You'll get a pound of rice a week.
Is that all?
Okay, 2 pounds. And half a pound of dried fish.
No sugar or eggs.
They both go to the hospital, you know that. What do you say?
I tell you what I say, Colonel. I'm going to go to Colonel Smedley Taylor, and I'm going to tell him what you've just said. I'm going to show him this. And if there's a borehole party, and I pray there will be, I'm going to ask to lead it, and I'm personally going to shove you down. But not too fast, because I want to hear you scream for a long, long time before you die.
Oh, my God.
Well, I've seen Lieutenant Colonel Jones, Quartermaster Sergeant Blakely, and relieve them of their duties, as of today. And now we'll forget the matter. I say we, because you are to forget it with me. In fact, I'll make it an order. You're to forget it ever happened.
But we can't do that, sir. We caught them red-handed stealing the camp food. That's your food and mine. They deserve to be topped.
Nevertheless, under the circumstances, this is the decision I've made.
But under what circumstances, sir? You can't let them off scot-free. You just bloody can't.
Don't tell me what I can or cannot do, Lieutenant.
I'm sorry, sir. Look, sir, those men are thieves. I caught them.
I repeat, the incident is closed.
By God, it's not closed. I won't let it be closed. They've been eating while we've been starving, and I insist
you
that they be...
insist on anything, Lieutenant. I intend sending the following to the camp commandant. I strongly commend Lieutenant Robin Gray, Royal Tank Corps, for his work as Provost Marshal Changi Prison. His consistent performance of duty in difficult surroundings is beyond question of the highest order. I would like to recommend that he be given the acting rank of captain.
You hypocrite. I think you're in with them. Well, you're none of you going to get away with it. I can't prove anything against you yet, but I've got proof against the other two because I've got this weight.
What about the weight, Lieutenant? I said, what about the weight?
This isn't the same. This isn't the one I gave you.
You're quite wrong, Lieutenant. It's exactly the same one. Now, you're a young man, Gray. I understand you want to stay in the army when the war's over, eh? Well, that's good. The army can use hard-working intelligent officers. I'm sure that I could prevail on the commandant to add to my recommendation that you be granted a permanent commission. You're just overwrought at the moment. It's understandably so. These are terrible times, Gray. Terrible times. But we must get them into the right perspective. I consider it imperative that we let this tragic matter drop. For all our sakes. No good purpose could possibly be served. I'm sure when you've chance to think it over as carefully as I have, you'll appreciate the wisdom of my decision. So, have you any objection to my sending this forward? Good. We can take it as read then. Is confirmed.